Judgy, time. It's 1:13. Hi, everybody. Big Joe Henry having all kinds of fun. We're here at the 5th annual Asbury Park Music and Film Festival. And what a great festival this is. It gets, like me, it gets bigger every year. And I'm just having a blast this year so far, and things are kicking off. And with me, one of my good friends, he's the founder and principal of Halo Group. He is the executive producer, the writer and director of a movie that premieres tomorrow, Asbury Park, Riot, Redemption, Rock and Roll. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Tom Jones is here. Tom, how are you, pal?
Big Joe. Just good. How are you, buddy?
I am so, so excited for your movie tomorrow, and it's been a long, arduous process for you to put it together, but boy, was it worth the wait.
It's been a slog, but it's going to be great. Just great. We're looking forward to it. I got a guy named Big Joe Henry in this movie. I don't know. You ever hear of him?
I had the privilege of narrating this fine piece of work, and the great thing about this movie is it really brings into light the story of the upstage, but the story of Asbury Park and the music industry.
Yeah, Asbury Park is a great American story. It's a great American city. It's coming back. It's coming back in a big way. We like to think it's coming back better than ever. People kind of get all whistle about the days gone by, but the days gone by were good for just a few people. The future of Asbury Park is going to be good for everyone.
It really is.
Yeah, and we're hoping to play a part of that. And the movie goes into the long history of Asbury Park. Music's always been the thing here. It's the thing that's brought it back, and it's the thing that's going to take it up over the top.
And it really has. Really the roots. Bruce Springsteen and Stevie Van Zandt, Southside Johnny, Sonny Ken, all of them really brought. This was the beginning of what they used to do at the upstage.
That's right. At that time, there were 73 music venues in Asbury Park.
73.
1 square mile. And the upstage was the place all the best guys went after they were done with their paying gigs. They'd go upstairs, 3 floors above a Tom and Ken shoe store, and they'd play all their original material, 2 at night to 5 in the morning. And it was just a special place. It was only open a little time, but it had such an impact for so many people. And again, it was music. The only thing that crossed the tracks in Asbury Park, people go from the east side to the west side, the best musicians. It's the thing that knitted it up and connected it. And we think that says something that people not only here, but all around the world.
And what I also think is prevalent is that you also touch upon the fact of July 4th, 1970, with the race riots here.
Yeah.
And the burning down of most of Asbury Park. And you talked about the times, and they were very, very tough times for a lot of people. But you also talk about the using the word redemption and how things came back.
Yeah, and it's coming back in a big way. That what was really lost on July 4th of 1970 was the West Side. The West Side had a fantastic music scene. It was a big stop for R&B and blues. Everybody played there. Everyone from Ella Fitzgerald, Dizzy Gillespie, fantastic artists. And that all went away. And it hasn't come back yet, but it's not for lack of trying. People are really trying here. They're putting their best foot forward, and I think the best days lie ahead.
It's a movie that if you love music, if you love the historic side of New Jersey, and such an important part of that is Asbury Park. And the movie premieres tomorrow at 3:30. Hurry and get your tickets because they're almost gone. Go to apmff.org. And we're going to do the movie. And then the great thing about this movie is that May 22nd,
that's it.
It opens into 1,400 theaters worldwide. And the great thing that I've done, I've got people in Florida and all over the country that know about your movie. And they said, Big Joe, is it coming to my theater? I said, I'm going to give these guys a plug and they're not doing anything for us. Fandango. You go to Fandango, you click on Asbury Park, Riot, Redemption, Rock and Roll, and you put in your zip code. And they'll tell you where the theaters are right by you to do that.
That's right. And it's in 28 countries, 1,400 theaters, Iceland to Islip.
That's great.
The best part of that is the way we have it set up is all the profits from the film go to support educational programs here in Asbury Park. And we're hoping to develop something really special with Stephen Van Zandt that we pilot here and take around the world. So it's
unbelievable.
The film's like a product of the festival. All the proceeds of the festival go to the same thing, to support music here in Asbury Park for kids who otherwise wouldn't get a chance at it, and it's so important, and we're super proud about that.
Well, it's good, and I just want to make a mention. May 22nd, I will be with the Big Yellow Van and a van stop. We're going to be at the Freehold AMC Theater for the big thing, and I'm taking 25 of my closest friends, and we'll be there, and we'll talk a little bit about the movie. Tom Donovan will be with us. I know you'll be back in California.
Back in California.
And taking care, but you know we're going to be, our thoughts will be with you that day. And go see it. And if you can't make it here tomorrow, please, May 22nd, go see it. Find out where theater by you, and I'm telling you, and if you're here with us, come to Freehold. It's also going to be at Hazlitt on Route 35 at the Cinemark Theater in Hazlitt. So check that out and have some fun. And Tom, I love you. This movie is terrific, and I'm so looking forward to everybody seeing it. I got a little preview thanks to you, and man, it gives you chills. It really does.
Thank you so much. Tomorrow is going to be a fantastic day. Been looking forward to it.
I can't wait. I'll see you for sure. All right, let's check in with New Jersey 101.5 Fast Traffic.